Hello everybody, thank you for joining me today for another video in my ranking all 156 episodes of the original Twilight Zone series. Today I'm going to be talking about a season 4 episode, the first hour-long episode on my list, The Incredible World of Horace Ford, written by Reginald Rose and directed by Abner Biberman, I believe is how you say it. So, you know, like I said, this is an hour-long episode, and I know there's mixed feelings on those. I actually like a lot of the hour-long episodes quite a bit, but not this one, as it just feels very repetitive and very padded. So the biggest problem with this episode is the character of Horace Ford himself, played by Pat Hingle. I just find this character to be over the top and annoying. I think Hingle overplayed the part a little bit, but he may have been directed to do so, so I'll give the benefit of the doubt there. But I just don't care about this character. He feels very unreasonable to me. When other people talk to him, he just shouts and rants and raves. I get that he's supposed to be like somewhat disturbed about these visions of where he grew up are being, but it just seems a little overdone and forced to me. There's also this mother character, his mother, thrown into the episode, and she's over the top and annoying as well. Again, none of this just feels realistic to me. I did like the wife character in this episode, played by Nan Martin. That's one of the reasons this episode is a little bit has a little better positioning on the list than the three I've talked about so far. There was one character I kind of found somewhat interesting. But, you know, this episode's also very padded. We see, like, the same scene where he goes back to his childhood, like, three times. It's almost the exact same scene with just a little bit added each time. And it really doesn't work. It's very monotonous and very boring. And this whole episode just feels very padded. I think this one would have actually worked a lot better as a half-hour episode. There's just not enough material here for an hour, in my opinion. And again, this one has the fundamental problem, like most episodes I don't like. Why do I care if I can't really relate to the lead character or find them annoying in an unrealistic way? Like I always say, you can have an unlikable or unrealistic character if they're interesting. I just don't really find this guy to be interesting, to be honest. I just want him to kind of leave me alone, especially as the episode continues on and on. And, you know, the message of this episode is kind of interesting, that your childhood might not be like you like it, and maybe you don't want to go back again. You know, there's a lot of Twilight Zones about maybe you want to relive the past. In this one, it turns out Horace Ford may have been better off staying in the present, you know. So I like the message, but I don't think the execution of it's very good. So, you know, because there is one character I liked, and because I like the message, this episode ranks a little higher than a few others. But overall, I still just don't care much for The Incredible World of Horace Ford. This one's kind of a slog to get through every time I watch it. So that'll do it for my review of this episode, number 153, The Incredible World of Horace Ford. The next episode will be number 152, yet another episode I don't really like much at all. But there's only a few more of those left, so we're getting there slowly but surely, I guess. As always, feel free to leave me a comment on what you think about this episode. Maybe I missed something that you really like about it, or, you know, maybe I hit it just right. Thanks for your support, and thanks for watching.